Welcome to the web tutorial, Restricted Data in the PSID. To begin, let's go over what you can expect to learn. This tutorial has three sections: a description of available PSID restricted data files, an explanation of how to apply for PSID restricted data files, and an overview of using the restricted data in the Virtual Data Enclave. In order to safeguard the confidentiality of respondents, some PSID data are provided under contract between the researcher's institution and the University of Michigan. We refer to these data as restricted data files. There are three basic types of restricted files: files with geographic identifiers, administrative linkages, and other data that are considered either sensitive or that may potentially increase the risk of disclosure. Let's begin with an overview of available restricted data files. PSID provides approved users with geographic identifiers that make it possible to link PSID to contextual data from secondary sources, such as the census. Variables that indicate geographic location below the state level are restricted. There are six types of restricted geospatial files: the county identifiers file, the geocode match files, the between wave moves files, the employer geocode match files, the county where born or grew up files, and the county where child born file from the childbirth and adoption history. The county identifiers file and the geocode match files contain one record per family unit, reflecting the family's location at the time of their interview. The between wave moves files have up to six records for each family unit, reflecting the moves between waves experienced by the head or reference person. For the geocode match files, the between wave moves files, and the employer geocode match files, researchers may request tracked, block group, or block level files. Researchers who request these data must provide a research plan describing the analytic use of the data, including contextual data to be linked. For block group and census block, a detailed justification of why tracked is not adequate is also needed. The county where born or grew up geospatial files includes county-level data about where PSID individuals and their parents grew up. The county child born file includes county-level data about where children to PSID individuals were born, which has been asked since 1997. Restricted files with school identifiers are available for Maine PSID, the Child Development Supplement, and the Transition into Adulthood Supplement. These identifiers may be linked to the U.S. Department of Education's National Center for Education Statistics, NCES, Common Core Data, CCD, Private School Universe Survey, PSS, and Integrated Post-Secondary Education Data System, IPEDS. Each PSID family in every year through 2009, except 1969, for which the addresses are unavailable, has been identified as living in subsidized housing units. Subsidies may be provided by the U.S. Department of Housing and Urban Development, the Farmers Home Administration, through tax credits administered by the Department of Treasury, or through state housing programs. Starting in 2005, PSID asked respondents who were either age 65 or older or receiving Medicare to provide their Medicare number and consent to link to their Medicare records. PSID respondents who provided permission and descendants who have never refused permission have been matched to claims that begin in 1991. The Mortality File contains information about deaths of all individuals in the PSID who are known to have died from the beginning of the study through the most recent wave of data collection. Variables include the year in which PSID staff uncovered death information, month and year of death, age at death, location of birth and death, and an accuracy indicator for the date of death. Additional restricted files include sensitive data or fields that potentially increase the risk of disclosure. The Maine PSID has restricted information on vehicle make and model, as well as Asian ethnicity of heads or reference persons and spouse partners. Restricted data files are also available for PSID supplemental studies and modules. The 2014 Child Development Supplement has a restricted file with sensitive information, including sexual activity, delinquent behavior, and drug and alcohol use, while the Transition into Adulthood Supplement has restricted files with information about experiences with the criminal justice system, urbanicity, and Asian ethnicity. The Hurricane Katrina file has information from 2007 about the PSID's Gulf Coast families and their experiences following the 2005 hurricane. Three restricted files are available from the 2013 Rosters and Transfers module, containing information on place, distance to head or reference person and their spouse partner, and birth month and year of family members. The 2014 Childhood Retrospective Circumstances Study has a restricted file with sensitive information about childhood experiences. To obtain more information on the files that are available under restricted data contract, their file descriptions and codebooks, let's start at the PSID's homepage, psid.org. To begin, click on the Data tab in the menu that runs below the PSID banner. Next, click on the Restricted Data link, which will take you to the Restricted Data webpage. The left side of the page contains information for available restricted files for the main PSID, and the right side contains information for supplemental studies. As an example, by clicking on the node Geocode Match file, under Main Study and Geographic Information, you will see a link to the webpage containing a detailed file description, as well as either a codebook or variables list for that specific file. As restricted files are updated or new ones are released, additional information will be added to this webpage. To obtain access to PSID restricted data files, you will need to complete a restricted data application. To apply for restricted data other than Medicare linkages, the following items must be submitted through the PSID's help desk, psidhelp@umich.edu. A curriculum vitae for all researchers, a research plan, non-exempt institutional review board approval, a completed data request form, as well as the Virtual Data Enclave Acceptable Use Policy, Data Security Plan, and the Institute for Social Research's Confidentiality Pledge Forms for all researchers. Once the application packet has been approved, the administrative fee will be collected and the contract will be signed. For Medicare linkages, users first submit forms through PSID's help desk, including a data protection plan to receive data at their home institution. Once approved, users must then obtain a data use agreement from the Center for Medicare and Medicaid Services, or CMS. Currently, the Research Data Assistance Center manages the data use agreements process for PSID. Linkable claims are provided by the MedRIC division of Acumen LLC, and a crosswalk file is provided by PSID. For more information on the application process requirements, let's take a look at the Restricted Data webpage. The Restricted Data webpage has detailed instructions on the process for obtaining restricted data, including step-by-step instructions for each item in the application packet. There are also frequently asked questions for researchers applying for restricted data and for active contract holders. For active contract holders, a separate webpage contains information about existing contracts, instructions on citing the data in publications, as well as modifying or adding to a contract. Detailed guidelines for exporting results can be found on this page by following the link Data Disclosure Requirements and Guidelines for Exportation from the Enclave. This page explains the requirements for exporting results from the Enclave in detail. To close, let's discuss the use of the Virtual Data Enclave, or VDE. Once a contract is signed, access to the restricted data files, other than Medicare, is obtained through a Virtual Data Enclave, VDE, at the University of Michigan. Approved researchers will be given a username and password to use a virtual desktop in the Enclave. They will be given access to PSID public data files, approved restricted data files, and any approved user-provided files. Group folders can be set up to allow researchers on a given contract to share files. They will also have access to a standard set of statistical and other software programs, including Stata, R, SAS, and SPSS. There are strict rules for exporting results from the Virtual Data Enclave. Only reviewed output may be removed, and output is reviewed by PSID staff. No data sets or data elements may be removed from the Enclave. No maps, scatter plots, or graphs with any physical features may be removed. No output with cell sizes less than 11 may be removed. To facilitate disclosure review, summary statistics must be provided by researchers to demonstrate that the cell sizes are greater than or equal to 11. This web tutorial was produced by Nora Insulera and Vicki Friedman in collaboration with the Michigan Center on the Demography of Aging with funding from the National Institute on Aging. This ends the web tutorial on restricted data in the PSID. Comments and questions may be sent to psidhelp@umich.edu.